For the sake of truth, Ali Dawah and Mohammed Hijab, before him, refused a formal moderated debate with the apostate prophet. Instead, they resolved in ambush tactics and talk shows. So they wanted a talk show, a kind of Jerry Springer show. With full conscience and purposefully avoided to debate, and with cowardly tactics tried to stage a horror show made to humiliate their targets instead of intellectually engage with them. That was in fact the fourth time that happened.
He got bullied to death by Mohammed Hijab, mate.
If you like to attack the Quran, you will see today that the Quranic argument will suffocate you. It will suffocate you.
Let the bastard now come and justify himself. Come on, bastard, give us a call and justify yourself. Instead of talking about inshallah. Come on, let's see. Yeah, let's see what he has to say. Hey, bastard, go ahead. Tell us what you want to say about this.
Instead of engaging in honest debate, they stage clickbait confrontations meant to humiliate their interlocutor and then pretend to be heroes. That is a statement not only of their weak and scared arguments, but also on their shallow character. They don't have intellectual confidence. Moreover, that reflects to a general ideological codification in Islam that values supremacy over truth.
And on your Twitter,
is this worse? Is this worse than telling people that they should be put to death?
No, we don't condone it. Look, you're childish. Childish.
Then you're complaining about insulting, and then you're doing something which is insulting.
Is this worse?
That doesn't hurt us,
mate. You're just being disrespectful. What about the moral?
And they always give the same excuse of why they are doing it.
I apologize to all the other Christians here. Why? This man has made mockumentaries against Islam. He's attacked Muslims, aggravated Muslims. We know his story. He's not any regular Christian.
That is clear-cut victimhood mentality. Always playing the victims. And of course, that is trying to impose Islamic blasphemy laws on Western societies. Clear cut.
And the same thing happens with the Islamophobia industry. When they utter certain things, and you have individuals like the one who carried out the New Zealand Christchurch attack, you have people who take matters into their own hands and see Islam and the Muslims as their enemies and take the matters in their own hands by massacring 51 people. So therefore, when somebody like Apus, who has done videos where his following is like this, you know, general people as well, but also those who have a anti-hate, they have a hate towards Islam, they take the matters in their own hands.
Yeah, accusing the apostate prophet for the New Zealand massacre. That is abundantly absurd. The rise of Islamophobia, of course, is because of the rise of radical Islam, related to terrorist attacks and the backward, fascist, imperialistic, intolerant nature of political Islam. Nothing to do with YouTubers using their free speech and exposing the truth about Islam. In fact, channels like the Apostate Prophet will potentially reduce Islamophobia by exposing its cause, political Islam. In contrast, channels like Ali Dawah's increases Islamophobia exactly because they promote political Islam.
My wife, when she's walking down the road, when her hijab is ripped off, when I am walking down the road with a beard or a fob and somebody tries to run me over, and I'm not saying this happened to me, I'm saying these things that follow, this is a person who is outright, directly or indirectly, calling for the dehumanization of Muslims, especially somebody like Apus, who has done a video mocking the death of pilgrims. Pilgrims who have no weapons. In the Treaty of Hudaybiyah, when they were going to Mecca, they had no arms.
Okay, now let me show you the crime of the apostate prophet that caused the Christchurch massacre. Let's see.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. How are you guys doing? This is a quick response. I don't want to spend much time on this individual, but it's a quick response to a person who calls himself the apostate prophet, AP, who we've referred to as apostate pusillanimous. For short, you can call him a puss. A puss. This a puss individual is a vile creature who's on the record making fun and jokes about Hujjaj, people who had died in Hajj, who curses and insults the Prophet and Muslims and Islam on a regular basis. In fact, this is the only thing that individual does. His content, if not 95% of it, the vast majority of his content is just about attacking Islam and Muslims. So this is an Islamophobe, a person who we should give no respect to whatsoever. It's an atheist who's on the record believing in, saying that he believes that, for example, incest is morally acceptable.
I'm going to speak your language, yeah? You are a phony cuss. You know why you're phony? A puss.
So, you just accused the apostate prophet saying that incest is morally acceptable. You call him a pussy. You name him a pussy. You don't even call him by his own name.
He'll be like, no. Let's listen to this guy. His name is Apus.
Then Ali Dawah says that in an ideal world, he should be executed.
The capital punishment in Islamic law would be applied to you. We have no doubt, and we're proud of that.
But he is demonizing you.
Who's on the record making fun and jokes about Hujjaj, people who had died.
Be done quickly with a sharp knife by cutting the arteries on both sides while not decapitating it and harming the spinal cord. Then the animal must suffer, bleed out, and die.
Ridwan claims in his video that animals feel a significant amount of pain during the halal slaughter. However, in the description below, we are going to provide articles that will demonstrate how this assertion is false.
This picture is not from the apostate prophet's video. I put this picture to show what they are referring to as not so bad practice. Okay, please continue.
As you can tell from this image already, this is one of the most dangerous practices during the pilgrimage, because people move in large crowds quickly and aggressively and throw stones that can miss the pillars. Multiple incidents occurred in the past where the pilgrims killed each other in masses during this practice by accidentally trampling each other or hitting others with stones. In some incidents, thousands of people died.
Whoa, 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 whoa. What did he just say? Let's play that again.
That's what I call a sacrifice.
What does Ridwan actually say here? Oh, he's just making fun of people dying in a video where he complains about Muslims being too mean to animals.
So, Islam makes a blood ritual in the 21st century. Then he makes a stupid another ritual where people are throwing stones that resulted to 1,000 people died. Okay, this stupid cult just killed 1,000 people. And the apostate prophet made the connection, the logical sequence. Wow, that's also a sacrifice. It's a cruel comment that he muted, but it also has some logical sequence. It was not out of the blue.
By accidentally trampling each other or hitting others with stones. In some incidents, thousands of people died.
So, Mohammed Hijab searched 100 videos of the apostate prophet. Literally, okay? This was in a respond video of 100 videos of the apostate prophet. Found a muted, cruel comment. He was reading his lips and got outraged. Okay? He lost it. He got outraged. Then Mohammed Hijab celebrated Hakikachu, making this comment.
Daniel shared this joke on Twitter. Oh man, I missed the International Day Against Homophobia. The best way to celebrate such a beautiful, momentous, important day is the Muslim way. Recreational base jumping. Daniel Hakikachu here is referencing the Islamic punishment to execute gay people by throwing them off a high place.
Yeah, and so what he does quite effectively is he synthesizes his secular knowledge and with classical Islamic knowledge that he's also acquired through training and to make robust arguments against people who are against Islam Muslims. And the first thing we need to probably talk about, because it's quite hot now in terms of social media, is your debate with this the apostate Rizwan, which went quite viral and was quite a destruction, even by the admission of some of his fans.
So, Mohammed Hijab, you scientist, when you Hakikatsu, who made this kind of comment, making fun of gay people being executed by ISIS, that was not something terrible, eh? But a muted comment about some people dying by the stupid rituals with the bloodbaths. That was the insulting. Okay, that is the level of these buffoons. Anyway, so that was the crime. They are boasting. Mohammed Hijab, to tell you the truth, bro, brother, to tell you the truth, you don't give a rat's ass about human suffering. Muslim or not. The only thing you care, Mohammed Hijab, to tell you the truth, bro, is Islamic supremacy. So, don't pretend to be a philanthropist. You are insulted. You care about the suffering of people. Okay. You only care to attack an apostate the same way Hitler attacked Jews. The same mindset. You hate him because he is an apostate, not because he made evil deeds. Okay, Mohammed. You Mother Teresa, caring for the suffering of the world. You care. We care for women's safety.
Mr. Chung. Prepare to fire.
To all the members of the Nobel Committee, ladies.
Fire. Ready? Aim.
Innocent individuals who are going to do pilgrimage. And this individual here, Apus, mocks the death of these individuals. You have dehumanized Muslims to a certain level where individuals who watch your video, I believe the individual who carried out the Christchurch attack, if he was to watch your video, would he say, I changed my mind about Muslims, or I think I should carry extra bullets?
Guys, please try to comprehend the irony here. Okay. Ali Dawah invited an apostate for a cursing fest. This is how he called that. He invited him for a cursing fest. In other words, he will invoke his God to curse this apostate. And in this cursing fest, he is complaining about demonization. That is what is happening. Guys, this kind of stupidity breaks every limit. Okay, I have never witnessed this kind of blunt irony and stupidity. It's like a Greek tragedy, guys. Oedipus killed his father and married his mother. Okay, this kind of stupidity is demonization, guys. Now I'm talking about real demonization. It's from the devil. Ali Dawah is demonized. Now I'm demonizing him. What can I say, my friend? Moreover, Ali Dawah, let me explain what happened in Christ's church. Why this murderer, this animal, said that he did this action? Why? Let me tell you why. What he said, why he said he did this action. He said that he snapped when he heard in the news a truck or a bus running over a little girl who was deaf and couldn't hear the bus coming. Guess who was driving this bus? Ali Dawah. Who was driving this bus? A Muslim terrorist. So, Christ's church, although sick as it is, was a reaction to Islamic terrorism. Okay, so, we have 99% of terrorist attacks done by Muslim terrorists. You have 1% of the terrorist attacks done by someone else, and even that 1% is a reaction of Muslim terrorism. So what's the issue here?
That is the reason why I'm doing the open curse, because you are an individual who I believe indirectly have caused the life of innocent Muslims. I'm not saying directly. You do not go and say, go out and kill Muslims. So that is the reason why we're doing the curse, just to clarify. Okay. Does that make sense?
Sure. Thank you for the preaching session. I want to ask you something in return to that, just so I can give a response to that as well.
And I know what you're going to say.
I'm sure you have watched many of my videos. You've posted about me for weeks now, where you post about all the stuff that I talk about in my videos. Are you aware that I posted many videos, including one that is dedicated, in which I explain that I do not hate Muslims, that I find it wrong to hate Muslims, and that I condemn violence and discrimination against people? Are you aware of that?
Can I answer?
Sure.
Yeah, I'm just asking, so I don't want... Just quickly, you cut me off. And it's the interview. So, I confronted many people. I'm not someone that's in my bedroom. I don't stay in my bedroom like a keyboard warrior.
Okay, can you just answer my question?
Let me be straight frank. That's the one issue that I had with you. You're in your little bedroom, face-to-face, because Tommy Robinson, Britain First, Paul Golding, Avi Yemeni, Lawrence Southern, the list goes on. I come face-to-face, yeah? I don't sit in my bedroom and like Tommy Robinson, yeah?
Guys, this... person, let's not curse, okay, cannot understand the irony of saying I want to confront you face to face. What that implies? That you have an intellectual argument? No, you want to intimidate the Apostate Prophet. Can you not understand the irony of what you are saying?
These individuals say the same thing. You know what they say to me? Ali, I've got an issue with Islam. I haven't got an issue with the Muslims. Well, I'm like, hold on a second, mate. Andres Breivik, who carried out another massacre, yeah? I think it was Sweden, if I'm not mistaken, yeah? In that country, in his manifesto, if I'm not mistaken, he also mentioned Ayan Hirsi, yeah? And if I'm not mistaken, Tommy Robinson was also mentioned along those lines. When these people, and also my, I want to say my local mosque in Finsbury Park, where my in-laws stay, my in-laws.
You idiot. You think that in the decade of ISIS, psychopaths need the Apostate Prophet to be pissed against Islam. They just need to open the news and every day they see terrorist attacks. In the time of ISIS, you think that the psychopaths who want to have a bad idea about Islam, they are waiting Apostate Prophet in a mute comment to say something that might seem insulting if you see it 20 times backwards? Do you seriously think that? They don't have everyday sceneries from the news with terrorists, Afghanistan, ISIS, blah, blah, Boko Haram, Al-Qaeda, buses running, beheadings, they blowing themselves up in schools, in playgrounds. They are waiting the Apostate Prophet in a muted comment. They go back and forth the tape to see, did he insult it? Now I'm pissed. Are you serious, my friend? This is your argument, my friend, right now. Ali Dawah, focus, my friend. Do you think this guy, he was not cool. He was minding his own business. And he was happy, in a happy family. And suddenly he ran to the Apostate Prophet video he did before 3 years, and he saw this.
Whoa. What did he just say? Let's play that again.
That's what I call a sacrifice.
What does Advan actually say here? Oh, he's just making fun of people dying in a video where he complains about Muslims being too mean to animals.
And he said, that does it. That does it. He's too mean to animals. Let me see that tape back again. Let's go back. Let me read his lips because it's a muted comment. Okay, if I read his lips, he said that he's too cruel to animals, although Are you serious, my friend? This is literally your argument, that the Christchurch killer saw an apostate prophet video saying that, and he took a machine gun and started killing, shooting children. Are you serious, my friend? Anyway, let's continue.
A man drove a van into Muslims. Yeah, this man was inspired by Tommy Robinson. Now you go to Tommy Robinson, which is now
Ali Dawah. Are you seriously going to refer to mention van and buses running over people? Why you think that happened? Maybe it was a reaction of Muslim terrorists doing that. The incidents you are referring to, I think one or two people died. How about the 40 and 50 people that die in every bus run by a terrorist, a Muslim terrorist? How about that? Are you seriously going to utter the word bus accusing an apostate? You will utter the word bus. Are you seriously? You dare to say the word bus running over people, accusing non-Muslims. Are you serious, my friend?
Country, in his manifesto, if I'm not mistaken, he also mentioned Ayan Hirsi, yeah? And if I'm not mistaken, Tommy Robinson was also mentioned along those lines. When these people, and also my, I want to say my local mosque in Finsbury Park, where my in-laws stay, a man drove a van into Muslims, yeah? This man was inspired by Tommy Robinson. Now, you go to Tommy Robinson, which is now classed as one of 20 terrorists in the UK. He's, by name, it's been officially announced by the Met Police.
Guys, Tommy Robinson is a hero. Quite simple. He is a hero that sacrificed his own well-being to confront radical Islam with great personal sacrifice. Tommy Robinson is confronting radical Islamists. Okay. Unless you are a radical Islamist, Ali Dawah, why you are against Tommy Robinson? Tommy Robinson started from Luton. I used to be a student in Luton, in the university. Okay. Look what was happening in Luton that Tommy Robinson saw, and he started his activism.
Haters were shouted down. Many who'd come to welcome the regiment and support the parade felt the demonstration should not have been allowed.
Demonstration? Disgusting. Absolutely disgusting.
If they've got something to protest about, there's a time and a place for it. Get a petition, go to Downing Street.
My friend, if you come to Greece and start cursing the soldiers in a parade, not even Jesus, my friend, if Jesus comes to protect you, they will kill Jesus. Okay, they will kill Jesus. Okay. Are you serious, my friend? In a parade, you came and you start cursing the soldiers. Okay. Tommy Robinson, in other words, is a product of your endless provocations. Okay. Are you serious, my friend? In a parade. And that was the least of it. Radical Islamists in Luton were doing things, were bullying everybody, were converting 13-year-old kids to radical Islam. They were forcing elderly out of their homes. In Luton was the center of radical Islam of Europe. And you have an English lad that reacted on that in a moderated way. So, what's the problem? Toby Robinson, an English lad that spoke against radical Islam. Are you serious, my friend? Anyway.
Terror unit. He says the same thing. He says, look, man, I always say Muslims are my friends. Oh, I joke with Muslims, this, that. Man, you are the same scumbag when I confronted you, you couldn't even bring one verse. This is Tommy Robinson, by the way. Yeah? So I say the same thing. And he says exactly what you said. Ali, I do videos. I clarify. I'm not a hate preacher. But that guy driving the van didn't say, Tommy was telling me he, Muslims are okay. He went directly to kill innocent people and one person died.
One person died. So a copycat killer of Islamic terrorist. Okay, he killed one person. A copycat killer of Islamic terrorism. And you are accusing the apostate prophet of instigating that. Not the countless examples of Islamic terrorists doing that. So it's not Islamic terrorism that brought that. It's the apostate prophet. Are you mentally retarded? You idiot. What can I say, guys? Imagine the tragedy that I'm even laughing in front of these tragedies. Anyway, let's continue.
So you have blood on your hands indirectly or directly?
Ali Dawah, you retard. Okay, so you are retarded, obviously. So, okay, now stop talking and listen. For Islamophobia, there is one reason to blame. And this can be shown in statistics. Okay, after 9/11, we had Islamophobia. Okay, and the reason for Islamophobia is Islamic terrorism. Simple as that. Not the apostate prophet, not, I don't know, some background muted word that the apostate prophet said before 102 videos. Not that, it's Islamic terrorism.
No matter okay. How hard you try, you can't stop us now. No matter how hard you try.